Okay.
Now I'd like to call the special meeting of the Palmyra-Eagle School District Board to order at 5:40. And can we have a roll call?
Jean Reith. Mitzi Rashevsky.
Here.
Michael Eddy. Tara Leroy.
Here.
Zachary Rakowski.
Here.
Christiana Williams.
Here.
Doris Parsons.
Here. We do have a quorum. We do miss Jean and Michael. I will now read the district mission statement. To ensure that students excel with intellect and virtue, inspired by innovative educators who engage and challenge each individual. If you'd all join me for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Of the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Are there any changes or additions to the agenda?
I would like to move
which one was that, Seth?
D4.
The music teacher?
Yeah, I just have questions about that.
Is there a second to moving that?
I'll second.
Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
All right, so we're going to move D4 to action items. Any other changes or additions to the agenda?
Yeah.
Could I have a motion to approve the agenda as amended?
I'll make a motion to approve the agenda as amended.
Second that.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Motion carries. Can we have a motion to approve the consent agenda? Discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Consent agenda is approved. Okay. Action items. A, consider approval of administrative assistant registrar contract for the 2020-2021 school year. All of these contracts were in all your board packets, so everybody has those. And motion for that one.
I'll make a motion to consider the approval of administrative assistant registrar contract for the 2021 school year.
I'll second.
Any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Action item B, buildings and grounds director.
Discussion? I look forward to seeing great things she does. And I appreciate the extra effort that
Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Welcome, Bailey. All right, E, District Administrative Assistant Contract. Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Welcome, Carlin. And Carlin is correct, right?
Yeah.
Good to have you. Okay, F, consider approval of increasing the ACH transfer limits for payroll. This was discussed in finance. Is there a motion to approve that? Any further discussion or questions? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. G, approval of the extension for short-term borrowing loan for $600,000 from November 1st.
I can hear. I'm not sure if the mic here will pick it up.
Yeah, if you can hear right, that's important, and I think that's good to get out there.
Well, this move is just to, it's just moving the loan that was due on June 1st to November 1st. So there's no new borrowings or there's no, And whenever you do a short-term loan like this one, it is to be repaid every year. So you have to pay it back. Normally, school districts pay it back in November 1st. Because of what had been said about the dissolution and everything, that's why we had it set for June. And so now we know we're not going anywhere, and this is just going to keep going. It makes sense to just make it so when we have the next loan, we can just pay this one back. And it also allows us to collect the taxes that are due in August. So once we have that money, we should be able to pay for that. We have good, amounts of money in the bank, enough to carry us through August. And then August, when we get the money, we should be able to then pay those $600,000. The November 1st is a little bit of a, extra time. I would use it, but depends on how funds go. And I wanted to clarify as well, the short-term borrowing is not an income and an expense. It's just a balance item. Just, put it in the bank, put in a liability, and then when you pay back, you take them the opposite. And so it doesn't increase costs, it doesn't increase revenue either.
Thank you, Al. Any other discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. H, consider approval of the following revisions to the co-curricular pay schedule. We can do them. We should probably do them separately. So H1 is the addition of wraparound care program coordinator via stipend. There's an amount listed. I'm assuming, I don't know, Al, if you know anything about that, but it would be what they're asking, what Katie talked about a little bit, is that we would give a stipend to a current staff member to be the one who coordinates this and organizes it. And then once that's decided how much time it's going to take, then we would approve the amount. But right now we just need to approve the fact that she would like to open it up and post it for one of our district staff members to go for it. Do we have a motion to approve that?
I would move to approve the addition of wraparound care program coordinator stipend to be determined upon hiring.
I'll second that.
Any further discussion? All those in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Passes. H number two is increasing the FFA advisor pay.
I'll make a motion to consider approval increasing the FFA advisor pay to $3,500, $3,750, $4,350, $4,500 respectively.
Is there a second? Further discussion?
I would just like to say that I think it would be fiscally responsible for us. First of all, what is the current stipend? Do you have that available, Al? Because that's not available to us.
Unfortunately, she just decided to.
I believe it's less than 14. It's between 11, 25, and 14.
That's what I thought.
Yes.
That's kind of what I was thinking. So we're making it like three times as much, basically. My other thing is that I think we need to be fiscally responsible and approve 1 year, evaluate, and then we can look at subsequent years. This is a unique circumstance. I did do some research. I contacted a couple. There are people that I know in the industry. There are people who still have it as their normal teaching contract with extra days in the summer and stuff. They do have to report how many students they have participating in what activities. And those were professionals within this field, and they thought it was very appropriate and responsible to ask for that kind of documentation. They did not think that my thoughts were outlandish or inconsiderate at all. They just thought it was fiscally responsible. So my suggestion and my preference would be that we only consider the first year raise of $3,500 with stipulations that things are reported to us, and then we reevaluate the following year. I think it's prudent on our part to continue to evaluate, because this will set precedent for not only FFA, but if we have industrial arts activities, if we ever add back to the FACE program and have those, if we ever have FBLA, DECA, any of those other co-curricular activities, this can suddenly become not just $3,500, it can become $20,000 extra that we're adding in. Those are my personal vehicles.
I like doing it 1 year at a time.
Any further comments?
So then what do we do to re-change?
Tara, would you consider making an amendment to your motion? That it just be 1 year, or we can vote that motion down and make a new one. Either one would be fine.
Let's vote it down.
Okay, then all of those in favor of the motion to approve as was written in our packet with a 4-year increase, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That motion fails. Can we have another motion?
I would move to approve the FFA advisor pay to $3,500 for the first year with review upon documentation for further years.
There a second? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? That one passes. Okay, H, would be H3, so this is one there, but it's three. Credit recovery stipend. That is, was also, we received the information from Carrie Tim. It's for a stipend for a staff member to be working this summer with those students that didn't receive the credits they should have with the virtual learning, and she gave us the number, there were quite a few of them. So we would need, Al, did you have an amount that she was, I don't know that that came with an amount either, she just wanted to see if we could get someone to work with those students.
Yes, I think that's the one that is about 3,000.
Discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Okay. Now we've got a nice list of the second reading of the following revised policies. We had the first reading last meeting. Now, I would think these could all be done in one swoop. Christiana probably wants to take that on, so.
I make a motion to consider approval of the second reading of the following revised policies as recommended by NEOLA. Section 0000, section 1000, section 2000, section 3000, section 4000, section 5000, section 6,000, section 7,000, section 8,000, and section 9,000.
I'll second that.
Any further discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. And then J, which would be the second reading of the new policy for the district and school report cards as recommended by NEOLA.
I'll make a motion to consider approval of the second reading of the new policy, policy number 2261.03, district and school report cards as recommended by NEOLA.
Second that.
Any further discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. And then we will move to the item that was changed from the consent agenda, which is D4, the music teacher at Eagle Elementary School. So we have a, let's have a motion to approve that in a second, and then we can discuss it.
I'll make a motion to approve hiring the Eagle Elementary music teacher.
I will second.
We have a motion and a second. Is there any comments, questions?
Yes. sixth grade band was going to be done by Scott Hine here in this building.
I think that's what Carrie said.
Because where else are you going to do band? A band room?
I wasn't sure if sixth grade was going to be band. I wasn't sure if fifth grade was. I apologize, I don't recall her the list of the contracts.
Because it was probably under the consent agenda, it wasn't individualized, so that's a good question.
It's on the list.
It's on this list.
No, previous.
Oh, previous.
The list of all the teachers we approved.
Well, we can vote down this motion and table it and get more information, bring it back. So, all those in favor of approving the elementary school music teacher, say aye. All those opposed? Can we have a motion to table that and still consider the approval at our next meeting? Discussion? All those in favor? Opposed? If there's some issue with us needing to approve that by July 1st, we can have a Zoom meeting and actually approve it and talk about it once we get the information. So I would suggest that perhaps we could get more information to the board and then figure out if there's a way the training session before that, but even if we had to just do virtually get together and approve it, I think it's just we just need information.
So the question would be if it's possible to join to do music with the same person, right? Music and band.
Well, it sounds like we have questions on whether we're going to have a band in the curriculum for fifth to sixth grade next year.
I think I thought we talked about having it there, but I just how we're going to handle staffing. Could be half a split time too or something. I think in curriculum and policy, Carrie said that sixth grade was going to fall under 7 and 8, like you interpreted. I believe that's where when she spoke to us in that meeting.
Do you know what it is?
Katie's shaking her head.
The plan was Hine doing 7 and 8 and Fock doing 6. So which is the elementary.
So she'd be doing 5th and 6?
Yes.
And
so traveling between the two buildings doing 5th and 6th.
That was a plan.
Thank you. And those are full-time positions.
Well, you're that would be
she's doing recess duty and lunch duties as well.
And she's been traveling between Palmyra Elementary and Eagle Elementary. And they do I'm sure they do lessons too as well as just
there's lessons.
So our specific questions are, we would like to see what the breakdown is and what the hours are, time frame.
Making sure we're not duplicating.
Right.
That was my concern. I wasn't sure what the duties would be of the band teacher.
So it's just more information needed, and again, if we have to do that before July 1st, we'll get together and do that.
And I was going to say, it's, well, obviously for the teacher, it will be, but at the same time, I think as long as the position is justifiable, they shouldn't have any issues with it. And we can always guarantee that we'll just ask questions. It's just a question that you have. And at the same time, the release start September,
difficult to make a decision when we don't have a superintendent here either, or principals to answer our questions. So.
And that could go beyond what Katie just said. It's meant to be like that. And yeah, the principals is probably a good idea to have a comment and just a question.
Yeah, so no one here wants to cut any type of our music program or band program at all. We're not saying that at all. We're just saying we want to make sure we're using the staff members in the best, most efficient way, and we just want to know that.
Right.
Thank you. Yes. Okay, district administrator's report, we don't have one. We don't have one here. But did you have anything you want to say, Alice? Is one of our top administrators? Tracy's got something.
I don't believe you guys, you did. Guys did the motion the second to table it, but I don't think you guys did the actual vote to table it.
We did vote on the tabling.
Oh, all right. Let's go back to that. We had a motion and a second. All those in favor of tabling upon receiving more information on the elementary music teacher as well as the band teacher, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Thank you, Tracy.
Do I have anything to add? No, I didn't think it's something I would have to wait for the next. If you want to have a little bit of an update of the finances, the Baird consultants, and basically we have adjusted some numbers, and because of the way that the membership comes, and you get some exemptions, that is frankly a lot of money, because it doesn't come as good as I had thought it could be, but still very good and better than what I have presented to you, which is, I'm calculating right now around 300 up, so the black 300 next year, pending some reviews of objects, services that could be, reduced for the next year, so we could be thinking of a better number than even that. And this is, taking into account that we are not going to have, Jeff has been telling me we're not going to have so many losses. We're going to have about the same residents in the school. So if we get our students back, we would get more money. But because we're not losing as many as I had told the machine, the spreadsheet, it's not giving us all of the money that, I don't know why it does this, but it just gives you more money if you lose a lot of things. The DPI is worsening. So I'm going to have a talk with DPI about it and say why. If I put 600, I have more money than if I put 900. It doesn't make sense at all. So I'll have more on that, but there's also good news on the loan side. We are structured right now, so yes, we're paying interest on the loan that we have for the Fund 38, which is the energy efficiencies. But at least from what Baird is telling me, and I do think that it's true, we can levy at the same level that we have to pay that year for the energy efficiency loans, meaning that once we stop with our referendum loan, which is in 2024-ish, so a little bit before 2023, let's say, in 2024 comes a tranche of those loans that are for energy efficiency. So we can levy it, and we can get that money from, it won't change the mill rate. We would still be levying the same amounts, and we would just be getting it from the same sources and property taxes. So we don't have to worry about not having money to pay those loans or refinancing it.
But it won't increase the mill rate?
Nope. On the contrary, the long-term referendum-based loan evaluation should be higher, unless if we have a, you know, a really bad situation coming in. I hope not. But unless something really bad happens, we're going to be pretty much even. Of course, may have a bit of an issue with raising salaries, making things efficient. But at the same time, I do think there's some areas to fund expenses. We've been talking about transportation, perhaps you know, trying to talk to those people and vendors and many other services that we may not need anymore, that we may need to review their contracts. As you saw, we had less of a premium in our buildings and over insurance for the property. So and even the workman's comp. So and that's because we're reviewing all those numbers and saying, well, they were considered that Palmyra was going to be closed, like mothballed. And I was like, no, wait, there's going to be people every day there. So it's not an empty building. It's not something that we're just going to have there sitting. There are going to be people every day coming by. And so they removed the denomination of it being closed, which is more risky, apparently, for them. Yeah, you go figure it. It's race. It's not going to burn, you know, even a fire wouldn't burn the whole thing, but they still, you know, want to cover their bases and then say, well, let's end it more. So all those cancer revisions, I'm sure that we're going to find some areas to save money in, and that should give us some money to be able to, you know, have a more equal pay and better salaries for the teacher, basically. That's what it translates to. I'm sure we're going to be reviewing positions during the year, like these, to be sure that we're as efficient as possible, and perhaps even, you know, talk about selling services or buying services from other districts around us, and just, you know, be able to make our operation as efficient as possible without losing those land or those services, even those you know, classes that we want to give it to.
So that's very good news, and we no longer to totally have to fear 2024.
No,
which is really good news.
And I thought it was the case because I was like, that's an energy efficiency that gets grandfathered, but I didn't want to say anything until I had, you know, good second, you know, reinforcing my opinion.
So can I say, just so make sure I heard it, so kind of in 23-24 we were thinking there was another, we had to pay off, something was coming due, but we're going to be already paid off one other liability, so that liability will be taken care of so that we don't have to raise money, because we'll now take the money we're paying that off and be able to pay off the new one that comes due.
Yes.
Okay.
So it just matches, it's like a, you know, the same. It's almost the same amount. We could even think of we're levying a little bit just to start paying off those beyond the interest. And so it would even reduce our interest payments. So this is thinking of long-term expenses, because from now until 2024, we're paying interest rates on the main principal. That doesn't go away. And so to make it a little bit less even, and our payments less then, it's just, you know, levying a little bit higher this time.
So we're not maxing the levy at this point. We're not maxing out on what our levy could.
Well, that is not taken as a levy. That doesn't count towards your maximum levy, because you still have the loans and you're going to pay the loans that are part of the district's liabilities. So I know that we can just levy a little bit higher and then pay off some parts of the loans. That doesn't count against your maximum levy. And perhaps some surplus revenue next year, depending on, you know, enrollment and everything that we need to check. And hopefully during this year we'll be able to restructure things so we can then next year make things fair for the teachers, make them more fair, on par with the market values of some salaries that we need to lower.
If we do have a surplus, can we use some of that to pay down debt or not? That's not allowed.
Yes, but I would.
Okay.
I would rather grow the general fund. Because if you pay for debt, then
it might be short in the future.
Yeah, you could be short in the future. You use 300 or something thousand that you could be using for us.
Or maintenance or something. Yeah.
Yeah, maintenance or something. That whatever we've been talking about, you know, could be one of those items that we just take care of, and you don't have to, you know, worry about our operation.
Any other questions for Al?
Just as from a taxpayer standpoint, just brief summary is they can anticipate a very stable mill rate over the next 4 years at this point, and we appear to be financially stable.
Stable, yes. I would though caution that as averages go, we are in the lower average for the area. So we don't have salaries that are, you know, comparable. It's people that want to live here, that want to come and teach, and that perhaps a starting point, or perhaps a great district because it is nearby, or because whatever the reason. But you can anticipate losing quite a few teachers every year, and that rotation is not very good for us. You lose a lot of, you know, expertise and experience, and maybe you have trained those teachers, and you have done something to enhance their instruction and their methodologies, and that can be expensive. Longer, more so than just, you know, paying a salary that's a part of that people don't want to go. Or maybe you want to come teach here because we not only have a good system, good community, and a good culture, but it's also something that pays them a reasonable amount that they want to do.
So we're good, we're stable financially, we're making it for years into the future without needing to go to referendum or raise taxes. What we would like to do is work at being even more efficient and more attractive to other students so that in the future we can raise teachers' salaries and be even more attractive. So we're actually at the point where we're looking at good things. We're no longer trying to dig ourselves out of the hole.
Yes.
We're out of the hole, and we're looking at rising further up to do good. Thank you, Miss.
Well, one other thing, too, is if everything comes back and we're looking like moving forward, if we start getting more kids back in our building, that would allow us to raise salaries too, because that garners more money and would free up an opportunity to, you know, to bring them.
Definitely. However, it would be up for discussion if we need more teachers.
Well, I guess not more teachers, I mean higher salaries.
Right, but
more teachers. Yeah. Or just increased salary or whatever.
Right. Good things to have.
You know, but I'm just saying, we can, like you're saying, we're kind of market value, we're a little lower than we need to be, but we could raise that also by just bringing, when we've started bringing more kids in and having more kids in our schools, then that allows us to be able to turn it around in terms of.
And I can see more certainly yes in the elementary, but perhaps for the high school, that's not the same.
Okay.
Because you may need to have more teachers for certain, you know, classes that are too big, or that would get too big. That's the only caveat that I would put there, a little note that I would say.
Yeah, I get
yes,
it. When you get more kids back, then you're going to maybe need more students, more teachers than that.
Yes.
I get it.
And mostly for the higher grades than for the lower ones, because I'm sure I know the numbers for the lower ones, but in high school it gets more complicated because of all, you know, all the options you're offering. But still,
good. Any other comments? Any other comments? Any announcements or further board comments not related to that?
By the executive director of Wisconsin Public Education Network. I actually had a meeting today with her and another woman putting together another summer summit. Some of you may remember last summer, Sue Fisher and I went up to La Crosse and we were part of a panel on referendums, which she told me today that actually ended up being like one of their most well-attended panels out of that particular session. And I've been invited back to be part of another panel. She said she has been hearing from everyone. They want to hear the follow-up to the Palmyra-Eagle story. She introduced me today as being from the little district that could. And so I've been invited to be part of a panel that talks about the importance and the power of civic engagement and that every vote matters and what an impact on a local level people can make that benefit children's education on a whole. And she really encourages us to share our story. I think this is a great opportunity to share at a statewide level some of the trials and tribulations, but the ultimate successes that we've had, the changes that we're able to make. And I think anytime any school has the opportunity to share something that has helped them and helped their kids, I think we have the responsibility to do that. So I am very proud to be asked back and to share a good story, the happy ending at this point. And that will be, it was supposed to be in person in Sunbury, but due to COVID, it's gonna be an online session. I don't have all the details yet, but it will be July 24th. So I'll be working to put something together for that. But I just wanted to share because I just found out more information today.
Okay, we have upcoming meetings. There's a four-day school week ad hoc committee meeting at 4 p.m. on Monday the 29th here at the IMC. Curriculum policy is meeting at 5:30 p.m. on Tuesday, July 7th in the community center. We have our board training through WASB at 6 in the evening on Monday, July 13th. It can be virtual or in person, so we will be having things set up here, but the WASB person will be coming in for Zoom. Building and Grounds Committee is meeting at 5:30 p.m. on Tuesday, July 14th. Finance Committee at 6 p.m. on Tuesday, July 14th. And were you maybe want to talk and see if that can be changed, or and our regular board meeting is at 7 p.m. on Tuesday, July 14th. One thing, just to make you all aware, at that regular board meeting, we're going to be hearing a presentation from our administrative team about our options for district due to COVID. But DPI's results came out yesterday, and they made suggestions, and it's still not set in stone what anyone has to do or what's going to happen. But what our leadership team is looking at is a three-tier option plan that they'll at least present to the board at this point in what those three tiers would be, because we will have to be voting on it, and obviously sooner than when school starts. So we're going to get a presentation of that. So we get a little bit more information. We'll get more information via email. Prior to that, so you can look at it and answer questions. But I think that's going to be really important. And just so you know, they're working really hard on trying to do the best thing. I actually think we're ahead of a lot of districts in what we've been doing and trying to do. And I think the smallness of our district is giving us way more options than a lot of the bigger schools have. And I think they're doing a good job. It's not a good situation, but it's nice to know we're in a district that's really moving ahead and looking at our positives, our negatives with it, what we can do, what we should do, and I think that'll be a real interesting presentation for all of us, so we'll be thinking about that. Can I have a motion to adjourn?
I move to adjourn.
Second.
All those in favor, say aye. Closed. We're adjourned at 6:30. That was such a nice meeting. You wanted to stay and chat?